Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to Vlog and Sell Jefe Sobe here. I know it's not wintertime anymore, but I love short ribs and I found some on sale that were a really good price. These are chuck short ribs, so they're not off the bone. This is part of the chuck roll, but they look really, really marbled very well. I'll just sear these in a pan. First, I want to start with all the mise en place that you're going to need. This was just easy to do. I just got some baby carrots. You're going to need carrots, celery, and onion. And then I got parsley stems that we'll put in when you're braising it. A couple onions, some garlic, tomatoes, tomato paste, and a little bit more expensive, but this is much needed, a little port wine. Got a total wine. Some beef stock, and I believe that's it for the braising process, and then I'll show you. But you don't want to use all your port wine here. You probably want to use maybe, half of it or so, and then leave the rest for the port wine sauce that we'll be doing later. So with that being said, let's cut up all the vegetables, and we'll get to cooking. We'll sear these off first, and then after that we'll put in the vegetables, and then deglaze it with some port wine. So yeah, let's get started. Go. What I have right here, I just very, very liberally salted and peppered the chuck short ribs. So I got a super smoking hot pan. I want to sear these and get a nice color on it. And then after that, we'll put in all our vegetables, as you see over here. Got those all chopped up. You don't have to be perfect. That's just going to be with our braising, those short ribs. All right, we've got a little smoke point right here. I'm using peanut oil. And then we'll just go ahead and probably put two in at a time. I don't think the pan will drop too much. Put more than two in there. So I think two is good for right now. We'll sear all these off. We got a pan right here, we'll put it in. Put the vegetables down first, and we'll put those right on top. And I got my oven set. Usually I do around 375 for a braised short rib, but I kicked it up to 390 because usually the convection ones you have at the restaurant are a little hotter. So do this for now, and I'll let you know when we get to the next step. Short ribs, good to go, nice sear on them. I'm gonna take these out real quick, like so, and then right to there, put a little bit more peanut oil in the pan. Still hot, now I'm just trying to get a nice char slash sear on all the vegetables. We got your tomatoes, celery, onions, carrots, a little bit of garlic, and then last, I'll add the port wine, and then I'll mix in a little bit of tomato paste, and then the beef stock. I'll cook off the port wine, cook off the alcohol, and then I'll put in the beef stock. And then we'll put all these vegetables at the bottom of the pan, put the short ribs right on top. And then we'll cover with tin foil, put it in the oven at 390, usually around 375 or so, for probably two to three hours, and they should be good, should be good to go. You'll know when they're done if they're pork tender, and you can pull a little bit of this off. So, gonna keep on sauteing these off, get a little color on them, like so, get all that goodness that was on the bottom of the pan. had a big rondo, which is basically just a big pan, but it's stainless steel, and it gets all that good, the good bits of meat that are on the bottom of the pan when you deglaze it. But I don't have anything that big. I'll just keep on sautéing these for a little bit. You don't gotta cook them the whole way because they're gonna cook in the oven. A little bit more of the sear. Once they're done with that, I'll add some pork rind. Alright, we got some pretty good color on there. So we'll go ahead and add our port wine. That's probably... It's a little over half of the bottle. I'm gonna just let that cook out. Add our tomato paste, and then our beef stock, and we're good to go. I might put a little bit more water in, but it should be high enough. I might put a little bit more in, but those are the short ribs. Put all the liquid, beef stock, tomato paste, and port wine and all that stuff in there, all the goodies. Put a little bit more salt and some cracked pepper in there. But other than that, I'm just going to wrap up tin foil and put it in the oven. And I'll let you see what it looks like when it comes out. Stay tuned. Alright guys, so this is super, super easy. I just have a little bit of chicken base in there, or chicken stock, with a little bit of carrots. I think I've showed you a video of this before, but I'm just gonna heat this up, get them so they're kind of the mushy consistency, and then all I'm gonna do is mix it with a little bit of heavy cream in my Vitamix, and it'll be a nice puree to put down, and then you'll put your potatoes down, and we'll have our Brussels sprouts, and it's gonna be pretty good. Stay tuned. Hey y'all, so we are back. These carrots are ready to go. All I'm gonna do is put it in the Vitamix, and then grab some heavy whipping cream, and maybe a little salt and pepper to taste, but I think in here we had enough chicken stock in there, and a little salt, so we should be good. So next time you see me, I'm gonna put these carrots in the Vitamix. If I can do this one-handed. So we'll turn this on. Put a little bit, some heavy cream in there. Like so. Too much. And then put this beast on high. Alright y'all, I think the shrimps are ready. Let's see how they come out.
Okay.
Little teaser. they look pretty good. They smell amazing.
Yeah, they do.
Alright, let's see. More to come. I'll show you when it's plated.
Alright guys, so here is basically the stock of what I was cooking the strawberries in. And then before that, I put in a little bit more of the port wine into my pot. I reduced a little bit, so you get a little richer flavor from it. And then add the rest of the stock in here, and then a little bit of slurry, so it's a cornstarch little recipe to kind of thicken this up a little bit. Then I'm just reducing a little bit. And in this pan right here, I got a little bit of some bacon fat to cook my Brussels sprouts. So I got this nice and hot. I'm gonna throw in my mirepoix, carrots, celery, and onions right in the pan. Let them cook. Saute it up. I'm gonna let that cook for a little bit, and then I'll also add the rest of the bacon. So I just rendered the bacon before time. And I'm just gonna cook it up. And then after that, I'll add in the rest of the Brussels sprouts. So I roasted these off again at 425 for around 10 to 15 minutes. And then at the end, I don't have any apple cider vinegar, but I'll add in a little bit of red wine pomegranate vinegar, and then some brown sugar, and that'll help caramelize the Brussels sprouts. And shout out to Chef John Michael. He's the one that kind of put me on to this Brussels sprout recipe, and it never fails. It's always good. So shout out to you. I'm going to cook this up, and when I get back, we're going to finish it all up. Ready? All right, we're ready to plate this. So I got my carrot puree here, my cup. Just put a little bit on the plate. Probably just go in the center here, like so. And then grab my nice Brussels sprouts, I guess, nice and caramelized. Grab a spoon. Like so. We'll probably put these kind of in the middle. I think the shard was pretty big, so it might take up a good amount of the plate. Take some potatoes. Like so. Maybe not too many. And then grab my short ribs over here. That right on top, and then last but not least, grab my demi. Has a nice consistency. It's kind of thickened up a little bit. And put that right on top. Like so. Maybe a little bit around. And voila. The Chef Sobe short rib. She'll look bad. She's gonna be nice. Alright guys, make sure you subscribe to Elfe Sobe. That's ELJDFE. Sobe on Instagram, and that's my YouTube channel. Enjoy guys. Bye.